can we cuddle just a little more? A little more won't hurt, I said. Then I will get the strength to walk out that door. Just give me 5 more, no, 10 minutes more.
I gotta show all the beautiful faces, you know? How are you? Everything's good, man.
Big fun. Oh yeah, hitting the rocks.
Yeah, okay. You've done this before.
Uh-huh.
Well,
she's crying.
There we go.
That's right.
He's dead. Put him to sleep. Well, Toby's up over
those
guys over there.
No, he's
just going to. Okay.
That thing has a life of his own. That umbrella, right?
Well, he was just practicing.
He was just practicing?
Yeah. To make sure it actually opens. And doesn't take us away. What we can do the Kermit T. Frog thing, you know, like, let's get thrown away.
Yeah.
Still holding on to the umbrella. I'll be back.
Here we are at Michael Packer's funeral, representing 5 Miles Utopia and all of our other Staten Island friends that could be here, okay?
Okay, we don't need the march of death. We need something else. Thank you.
together once in a while, but not often after that, and then went our separate ways. I moved up to Mystic, Connecticut, and I live in Rhode Island now. I've lived there forever, 30 years. And Michael would arrive, would show up in my life every couple of years, and it would be okay for a couple of days, and then the old Michael would start causing trouble. The police would be coming to my place. You know this guy, you know, that kind of thing. So I had to chase him away two or three times. And then he showed up in my place and stole a guitar from me. He knew what it was. He was seen, you know, there was a witness, and I tracked him down a little bit, but I tried to let it go. Tried to understand why perhaps he had come to this, and why me, and decided it wasn't about me, it was just a desperation. Tried to let it go, and for about a year I could not. I was still drinking, and I cursed him every day. I'll tell you what I said every day. I said, I hope he lives to be 100 years old and never has a day of peace. I said that every day for a year. And then I got sober, and people told me I shouldn't do that anymore. So I stopped doing that, and I started sending positive thoughts. And my phone rang. A year and a half after I stopped drinking and I was learning about being sober, I thought. And Michael called and, well, I answered the phone. Sam, it's Michael. I said, how you doing? He said, I stole your guitar. He said, I know you did. He said, I'm going to pay for it. I said, okay, how you doing? From that moment on, never had a better friend. And he paid me for the guitar, took a while, but I didn't care. Neither one of us. They paid a lot of attention. We played together a bunch of times. I spoke to him the Wednesday before he passed. Last thing he said, the last thing we talked about was getting together next month. So good. That's my story about Michael, and I learned more about being sober and forgiveness, and friendship, and love, and all that good stuff from my fault.
Thank you. Thank you. Let's do it.
It's always helpful, you know, to be in the right place at the wrong time, you know. And so, but this is the right time to be in this right place. So we're definitely going to enjoy today.
And we're getting blessed, right?
Oh, yes, you know, so we're getting blessed. We're having the air being drenched with a little bit of water, you know, to sprinkle it out.
And we're representing also all those people that can't be here for whatever reason.
Oh, yeah. And we are right. Representing all those people, all seven.
Because there are many people that want to be here.
Right, they can't.
They can't.
They still physically can't. Alright, so. You just talk. You ain't so big.
store that's old.
Hi, this is Bob from Tampa, Florida, and you're listening to the Long Island.
Also named Famous Poet. Many of her poems are about herself and her thrilling adventures with Clyde. She once wrote, "The road was so dimly lighted, there were no highway signs to guide. But they made up their minds. If all roads were blind, they wouldn't give up until they died. To my dearest partner in crime, Michael. Empty, that is how I feel. After having you in my life for 38 years, I feel completely vacant. My heart is broken. Your memory will always be buried deep inside me. When you departed, a piece of my soul left the earth. But I know it will be returned to me when we meet again. Every time I hear a train whistle, I will think of you. Thank you for your laughter. Thank you for your wisdom. And thank you for you being a part of my life. To my Clyde, I love you. You are mine forever and ever. You may be gone, but you will never be forgotten. You are my love, your loving partner.
Does anybody else have any memory, any type of... Miss Lynn Orman Weiss, she is the social media guru for the Chicago Blues. She goes back, is Alice Cooper with her? She used to do PR for Alice Cooper back when he was still drinking. Maybe she was helping him drink. I don't know what he was doing. Changed his life. Oh, she was there for the bad period. Right? But anyway, it's Lynn who's very instrumental. It's safe to say what's going to happen if Michael's guitar.
Yes, absolutely.
You know what? I'm not stealing your thunder. Okay, I'm getting out of the way. But anyway, Lynn flew in from Chicago yesterday. She's probably leaving again tomorrow. And she's the it girl for the blues in Chicago. And I don't think she could carry a tune or play an instrument.
Or put the period in the comma in the right place.
Right. Okay. Oh, and she writes for Big City Blues Magazine, which I edit. And she may have missed some basic grammar classes at somewhere along the way.
I know, but I collect really good stories.
Great stories.
I do.
Gives you something to do, right?
I'm a storyteller.
I'm sorry.
I'm a broadcaster in Chicago. And when Michael said he wanted to bring the Chicago Blues Awards, he had to fight with everybody. So this man, he was a man of justice, of hope, persistence. I mean, I never fought with anybody before in my life except for Michael, and then fell right back in love with him again. That was just Michael Packer. I have to say, I was a publicist for David Honeyboy Edwards. And that meant so much to Michael, Honeyboy, and his relationship. As a matter of fact, that's the picture of him on the front of the Facebook page. And Honeyboy was the blues, and I can say Michael Packer was the blues. The guitar that he played, with the blessing of Buddy Guy and Buddy Guy's Legends, will be hung on the wall at Buddy Guy's. We will continue to carry on his vision and his passion of Chicago Blues. It'll be now called the Michael Packer Chicago Blues. And we will carry on. I am the blues. I will forever play his narratives and his story and continue his legacy.
Thank you. Very nice. Thank you. And now, fresh off the Staten Island Expressway from St. Philip's Baptist Church is Pastor Tony Baker. Take it away, Pastor.
Good afternoon or good morning. Sorry for my delay.
Good evening, everybody. It's Mark Klein hanging out with you. Welcome to the Long Island Blues Warehouse, EKO Studios, Deer Park, New York, the official studio of the Blues Warehouse. Mark Klein hanging out with you. Tonight, we are talking to a musician that performed his very first gig at the age of 15 in New York City's own Bitter End. He has had a serious roller coaster ride of ups and downs in his life. He's played many of the big rooms around the country with many of the greats, and he had some dark days in his life where, unfortunately, he had to spend time at Rikers Island. tonight, we welcome this week's featured artist. He's New York Blues Hall of Fame ambassador, the Michael Packer Blues Band. Featuring Linda Pino, lead vocals on that.